or how do you rate that?
I think psychologically that's a big one for Derry, you know. After last week, we were glad to take a draw out of it at the finish up, even though we could have snatched a win. The journey that we've been on, Ciarán, you know, the Monaghan and Ulster semi-final, Armagh that goes to penalties, and then only having 2 weeks to prepare for Monaghan that have another look at you, and then Donegal are sitting taking a look at us last week, and they had two games in this weekend. Look at the rest of the results around the country this weekend and today. This was not going to be an easy task coming in here today to get any sort of victory. So the fact that we won by 5 points and probably have a bit of a feeling that we left quite a number of scores behind us and the goal chances we created, but if you weren't creating those chances it would be worse. It's a good sign that we're starting then. We've got a good spread of scores throughout our team today outside of Shane McGuigan, and there's been a lot documented and written about that. I think that's also a very positive. I think the subs that we used off the bench, a number of them had a good impact for us. We're in a good place with injuries at the minute, so no, all in all, I would have certainly took it after last Saturday evening, and I would have certainly took it this morning. So yeah, psychologically, big result for us.
I think aside from not scoring the goals, was that a concern that you just hadn't been really creating a pile of chances lately?
Yeah, but you have to take it's all relative to who you're playing and how they set up and whatnot as well. So the teams that we've played, we know each other inside out, and the fact that we're bloody playing Ulster teams all the time know us even better. So yeah, it was a concern in some degree, but Donegal played a slightly different style today, and that was when we were aware of that, and we felt we had the athleticism from deep to hurt them, you know. So it was, and that worked for us, but it'll be a different kettle of fish the next day and hopefully beyond, you know.
It was 2 year half backs scored.
Yeah.
The other halfback created.
Yeah, yeah.
So the runners from deep really made the difference there.
Yeah, yeah. That was something that we would have looked at, Colm. You know, it would have been something that we felt we could have hurt them on. And to be fair, we did no training this week, but we did quite a bit of work, video wise, and talking through different scenarios and different ways that we could get at Donegal. And so it was. To win by five and to have that impact was good. We left a few behind us as well. There's no doubt about it. I don't know what it was, but I felt we probably had another three very good goal chances at least, you know.
Yeah, yeah. And it was, you were looking for goals, obviously. That's you were playing for runners coming.
Yeah, we weren't planning to score as goals, but we would be of the philosophy of hunting goals anyway, and then take a point if it was on. And we spoke about that at half time, you know, not to be too deliberate in terms of looking goals, but goals are big scores psychologically, you know, even in that heat and even in terms of, you know, the psychology of the next kick out. And we just felt at half time that in terms of getting our hands in the ball, like we led by 3 points at half time playing against a slight breeze with very little ball, so we just felt, you know, kickouts was so huge, you know, our own kickouts in particular, and Sean Patton was so bloody dangerous on their kickouts as well. That was the biggest thing, and we felt and we agreed leaving the changing room, if we did better in kickouts, we'd have some chance of winning the game.
Ciarán, you're in a good position to top the group now, and you know, that happened to you in the quarter final against the third seed. Like, you know, you can really consolidate that now in 2 weeks.
Yeah, but that's a danger. So you look at that, we were sort of keeping a wee eye on that game earlier today with Clare, and yeah. Clare's a bit like another Ulster team for us. We've played them that many times over the last couple of years. They know us inside out, and that's dangerous if you're starting to think so. We just play that game totally on its own merits, and let Monaghan and Donegal slog it out. It's great that the three of us have something to play for. We're going through in first place, we're going through in second place, we're going through in third place. I think everybody would like to go through in first, but look at some of the teams that's probably going to be coming through as second or third seeds as well, and what that means. And we're used to playing games week in, week out. So look at, we'll take it whatever way we get it, you know. We just want to go and win the game and then take it from there, you know.
And back to the goals and creating the goals, is it, are you just having to reimagine things and chop and change things? There's a lot said over the last 18 months about the five inside, and is there a wee bit going away from that again, sort of trying to do something different and teams working that out a wee bit on you?
I think if you sit still and you don't evolve and you don't look at trying to be slightly ahead of the curve, you're in big trouble, you know. We're one of the most documented teams in the country in terms of how we're scrutinised and analysed, particularly in the last year to 18 18 months. So yeah, there's many different ways you can skin the cat. So look at where all those things are definitely parts of our conversations. But on any given day, you have to attack as the opposition defend, and it's really important that the players have the ability to sense that on the field. We have, and it's well documented that our players are very bright players, and they have the ability to coach each other, manage each other in the field, because when you go out, you have an idea what opposition are going to do, but you're not fully aware, and getting messages on from the sideline without a mirror for you is near impossible. So the players, they would have a number of aspects of a playbook that they would look at what opposition are doing certain things. We'll manoeuvre and we'll look at that slightly different. So so to answer your question, yeah, that is the aspects that we look at, because I think anybody worth their salt would do that.
Obviously, there's a bit to go in the year yet, but when it's all over, do you think the Ulster teams in particular will reflect on how hard they go at the Ulster Championship? Will that be affected, or?
Well, if ourselves and Armagh don't go deep into the Championship, that will be the narrative. If we do go deep into the Championship, it'll be the narrative that the Ulster Championship really prepares you and battle hardens you. Everybody's current ways in hindsight. Who knows at the minute? Probably in terms of freshness and whatnot, winning that Ulster is tough. Like, you know, you can see it's Armagh are finding it tough now. We partied for a few days, and to get back on the horse after that and the emotion of the penalties, that is tough. But I think if we can dust ourselves down and psychologically getting through that today is a big thing for us. You know, it almost creates a bit of a relief for us in some respects, and we have 2 weeks now to get prepared for Clare. That's also important for us. So to answer your question, who knows, but it was still an amazing occasion to win that Ulster double back to back in Clonus. But if it does come back to harm us later in the year, that'll probably be the prognosis that's what worked against us. You know,
is there a huge difference in the self-belief for the group now, Ciarán? Like, because, you know, a lot of these fellows would have been on the squad, of course, and the team were in Division 4, and now they're back-to-back Ulster champions, got to the semi-final last year. Like, you know.
Yeah. Look, they're the most modest, down-to-earth group of lads. I think that's reflected in how they play out on the field. They don't play with an awful lot of nastiness or aggression, or, you know, it's all very controlled, and that's their behaviours, their mannerisms. There's a lack of ego to them, but there's a quiet self-inner confidence. They're very, very comfortable in their own skin. They've had quite a lot of success at club level, school level, underage level, and now they've had success with Derry as back-to-back Ulster. So there's a confidence, but it's a quiet confidence. You know, so.
Thanks very much. Good morning.
Thanks, Ciarán.
Thank you.